research that will change your world. From the University of Calgary, U of C, this is Now.
What are biologists interested in? I mean, we only have to look around and wonder how come organisms are so particularly well suited to their environment. And that's really been one of the driving forces of the kind of questions that drive my research here at the University of Calgary. This is one of our research ponds where we study not only how and why organisms are particularly well suited to their environment, but what happens when that environment changes. And we use this research pond to study this in stickleback. So stickleback are a small fish minnow-like species that we find here in Alberta. They're no bigger than the size of your hand. And one of the great things about stickleback is that we can breed them in the lab, so we can eliminate the influence of the environment and study their genes. And once we understand what genes are associated with a particular trait like growth or temperature tolerance, we can then use that to then conduct experiments in semi-natural environments like these research ponds to see what happens when the environment changes. So is there evolution? And in this particular study, what we were able to show is that in a remarkably short period of time, stickleback evolved this tremendous ability to tolerate really cold temperatures in just three generations. So this was much faster than anyone had ever anticipated evolution to occur in the wild in the past. Now, climate change predictions state that the average mean temperatures will increase gradually over time, but also the frequency and occurrence of environmental extremes in association with temperature changes is also supposed to occur. So the question that we had in the context of stickleback evolution is, how would sticklebacks cope with rapid environmental change, specifically temperature changes? Certainly, when the environment changes, organisms will either migrate, adapt, or go extinct. At least in the case of this small fish, we were able to show that they were able to cope with the kind of environmental changes predicted by climate change. But that remains to be seen in other species, certainly. Yeah.